First news is right-wing pastor says God sent us coronavirus because of homosexuality. By the way, thank you to YouTube for me to, for when I say coronavirus, YouTube is like, no, 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 you can't say that. So guys, these videos get suppressed. Please share them. I don't know if Facebook does it as well, but apparently you're not allowed to say coronavirus on YouTube. So share them because YouTube and Facebook don't share these videos with other
people. Are you allowed to say COVID-19?
Yeah, I think, but actually that's what some YouTubers try to do to get around it, but apparently that also gets suppressed. Anyway, so let me read the summary of this news and then you guys can tell me what you think. And also in the live chat, guys, if you want to make sure we read your comments, tag Atheist Republic, say, you know, at Atheist Republic, and I'll try to read your comments. So Pastor Stephen Andrew of the USA Christian Church found a way to connect LGBTQ people, women who have abortions, and people who don't worship as he does with the epidemic. Well, I mean, come on, guys. This was so obvious that this is going to happen. Like, did we not all knew that this is going to happen? So the summary continues. So this is a quote by the pastor. Our safety is at stake since national disobedience of God's law brings danger and diseases such as coronavirus. But obeying God brings covenant protection. This is based on Exodus 15:26, Andrew said. God protects the USA from danger as the country repents of LGBT, false God, abortion, and other sins. He added that March is repent of LGBT Sin Month, which I doubt is what anyone is giving up for Lent. By the way, these jokes in the summary, I think Anna should not include the jokes for whoever wrote this article. Just put the news, because if we include the jokes from the article, we're like kind of like stealing the jokes. This is by these jokes by this sarcastic remark at the end of it is by Hemet Mehta from the Friendly Atheist. But yeah, I mean, come on. Everybody knew that this was going to happen. We knew that whenever there's some disaster happening, there's going to be Christians blaming this on sin. Muslims are going to blame this on sin. Hindus are going to blame this on sin. Jewish people are going to blame this on sin. We knew that this is going to happen. We're going to have people come, and also we're going to have a whole bunch of people saying this is, I haven't seen this, but I'm pretty sure some people are blaming this on Israel somehow, right? Like Zionist conspiracy Illuminati stuff. Rivka?
They're blaming it on Jews.
On Jews.
Yes.
Of course. Yeah. Of course. Like, of course. I haven't even seen it, but I know it.
That was from the get-go.
From the get-go.
Right? Well, Hindus are not blaming it on sin, actually. They're blaming it on westernization.
Ooh, but... Oh, yeah. That's a go-to thing for Hindus, though, isn't it?
Yeah, they don't like this Western culture, which is destroying the Indian culture and stuff.
It's really hard now to blame this on anything since it's a global thing. Like, you know, the top countries are China, Italy, South Korea, and Iran, I think, at the moment. These countries don't have much in common. So it's really hard to blame it on... Like, what is it, like, what is the sin that all these countries share? It's really hard to blame it on anything, right? So you have to, the only people that will have a narrative going is that the general sinfulness of the entire planet, right? But you know what? It would be amazing if Israel comes up with the vaccine, because that's what I'm hearing. Like, a lot of people are saying Israel is going to come up with the vaccine. So that you would think that if Israel comes up with the vaccine... People would be like, oh, what happened? You guys were anti-Israel, but now Israel is saving the planet. But I know what they would say. Even before they say it. I know this hasn't happened yet, and we don't even know if Israel is going to be the country that comes up with the vaccine. But I already know what the narrative is going to be if Israel comes up with the vaccine. They're going to be like, of course Israel comes up with the vaccine. This whole thing was Israel's invention so that they could sell the vaccine. And they're also going to say, this vaccine is a way to control the whole world. There's something in this vaccine, and this whole disease was an excuse so that Israel... could like somehow control the whole world with the vaccine. That's going to be the narrative. By the way, I know YouTube now thinks we're spreading conspiracy theories because YouTube's algorithm is so dumb that it doesn't understand that we're not saying these things. We're just saying these are the conspiracies that people are going to come up with. But yeah.
Well, the thing that's out there now is there's people that are saying, well, even if the Israelis come up with a vaccine, I'd rather die of this virus than take it. And then there's other people that I've seen, like some Iranian clerics are saying, well, if they come up with a vaccine, I guess I would take it. I mean, you know.
Oh, yeah.
So their hatred of either Jews or Israel, whichever, is sort of selective depending on, you know, themselves or the situation. So, yeah, but I've seen both. You know, I would never take it, or, well, you know, I'll suspend my hatred for this one instance. But the Israelis are actually handling the situation pretty intensely, but in terms of shutting down their country. So, but I was wanted to go back to this pastor.
Right.
This thing about blaming it on the gays, I mean, really, come on. You know, this is just a tired narrative that, come on, dude, really? We're done with that already. It's been going on forever. And, I mean, God keeps sending these disasters. So whatever this guy thinks he's doing, it's not working. I'm just tired of it. It's just ridiculous.
Actually, it is working because this guy wants to be on the news, and this virus is the way to get on the news right now. So don't consider them stupid. These guys know what they're doing.
I know it's not stupid. What I mean is it's not working in terms of the virus is what's for the gays. If there was a hurricane, it would be the gays' fault. Mm. If his house caught on fire, it would be the gays' fault. It's just, you know.
I thought gays were the hurricane. Shouldn't you guys, like, when gays were hurricanes, they should decide who's responsible for what. Gays are, like, weather-related stuff and also earthquakes. Abortion, I don't know, maybe do abortion for virus disease related stuff, make abortion for that. Like,
I thought earthquakes were women not covering themselves according to the cleric in Iran.
Yeah, that's Islamic stuff, but Christian stuff all
is always the gays.
Yeah, we did classify it, earthquakes and hurricanes because of gays, and trans people can destroy the fabrication of the universe itself. And
oh yeah,
like
trans
that.
People they somehow, like, based on what we heard, they can like change the change time and space. They should make a superhero movie based on this, that you have like a trans person, a gay person, and a woman that just constantly has babies and aborts them. Like, just, it's an abortion machine in her tummy, right? And they all have.
I already have the character prepared.
And they all have superpowers. So the woman is responsible for, like, this spreads disease. And the gay person just, like, storms and earthquakes. And the trans person is kind of like, what is that character? I forgot. In Watchmen.
You know,
what's
like
blue guy
the original character created, like, she's a trans woman and her powers are like to create, manipulate and destroy time, space and energy.
Right. So she's Kali, but she's trans. But you see, this is already exists out there. It's called anti-Semitism. they're always saying that this is everything. Jews control weather, the banks, the, you know, anything bad is their fault. Any response to the bad is, it's only good because you created the bad. Yeah, it's just, but I don't know how much more there is to say about it because
it feels like God's playing Play Gank on his smartphone.
Yeah.
You know the game Play Gank?
Yeah, I saw something about that. We've posted a funny meme about that on Atheist.
I think Drew also tweeted about that. Yeah. So.
All right. We spent too much on this one. Goodbye,
Pastor.
Good news. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, Why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And like, oh, they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But people are like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we don't think you want this. They're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah. Subscribe to our newsletter as well, and share our videos, because you know we do get demonetized, that's an obvious, on every one of our videos, so F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized, and that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized, what does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right and all that, you know, on people's homepages, and that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow, so we need you guys to share our videos. So